Bloody hell. We've been walking for hours. How much further now?
I don't know, Face, but I suspect quite a bit further.
Are we there yet? We've been walking for hours. Will it be much longer?
As I said before, Face, I don't know how much further we have to go.
Surely we must be nearly there.
Shut up, Face, for fuck's sake.
Guys, I keep hearing noises in this jungle. Can you hear them too?
The only noise I've heard for the last hour or so is you asking if we're nearly there yet. You sound just like my two boys when we go on holiday, but they are young kids.
Got to admit, mate, you are a little annoying, always asking how much longer.
Okay, fair point and taken on board, but forget that for a minute. Can't you hear the noises?
Nope, not heard anything, Face.
Me neither.
There it was again. Surely you heard it that time.
Fuck. What is it?
Not sure, but I suspect it might be trouble. We best be on our guard.
Quick, run. It's a fucking wipe. Run for your lives.
Guys, what the fuck? Don't leave me here. Nice monkey. Good gorilla. Guys, help. Oh fucking hell. Stop it, gorilla. Nice monkey. Guys, help. This gorilla has the hots for me and wants to shag me, I think.
Sorry, Face. There is no way we are going to come between a 500-pound horny male gorilla and his fuck. You're on your own.
Don't leave me here. Help me, you bastards.
The only thing I can suggest is to apply the lube, and from the look on the gorilla's face, I would do it fucking quickly. Oh my god, Prophet. We just lost Face to a horny gorilla. What are we going to tell the others?
Well, one thing we won't be telling them is how we ran away.
Okay, I agree with you on that, but what do we say about losing Face?
That he was captured by a 500-pound horny male gorilla that buggered him rotten, I guess. Not much else we can say, really. Now, let's push on and find this wise man in the jungle that might be able to help us find some cock.
Okay, lead the way then, Prophet.
Sure thing. Look up ahead. It looks like a teepee.
Hello, young lady and young man. What brings you to this part of the forest?
We have come to seek your guidance to help us find some cock for the queen.
I beg your pardon, young lady.
Sorry, I meant crystals of Congo. I didn't mean to be rude.
Excuse me, sir. Your dog is peeing on me.
Stop it, Haki.
Sir, do you know how or where we can find some cock?
There is no need to call me, sir. Just call me Rima, please.
Oh my god, Rima, your dog is shitting on me now.
Rocky, stop it.
I think we met once before in a cave in the desert. Was that you?
It was indeed, Prophet. And yes, I remember your name. Your friend, on the other hand, I do not know.
Allow me to introduce Anvar to you. Anvar, meet Rima. He used to be in Imperium a long time ago.
Nice to meet you, Rima. You were in Imperium when Azun was with us?
He recruited me way back when I was considerably younger. Unlike Azun, who looks damn good for his age, I have aged somewhat.
Wow, I didn't realize Azun was that old.
So, why are you looking for some crystals of Congo? They are very rare indeed.
It's a long story, but the short version is, we have been employed to find one for the Queen to wear at her Jubilee Parade in London on Saturday.
Well, you are in luck. I know where you can find one, but in exchange for this information, I want something from you.
That sounds fair under the circumstances. We agree to this, Rima.
I am getting old and have arthritis in both hands, so I find playing with the little chap difficult. If one of you gives me a hand job, I will tell you where to find a cock.
Quick, run. Run for your lives. It's a fucking perv.
Prophet, come back. You're kidding me, right, Rima?
Not at all, Anvar. If you want to find a cock, then I want you to give me a hand job. You agreed to this, remember?
I agreed because I didn't think you would ask for something as gross as this.
Well, I don't need to remind you of your pledge you make when joining Imperium, do I?
No. I'll do it. After all, what choice do I have?
Good lad, let's go inside my tent, where we won't be disturbed. Thanks for giving me head instead. Can you stick your finger up my ass too?
You don't look very well, Anvar. Are you okay?
I've just given an old man a blowjob and fingered his arse and you ask me, am I okay? No, I'm fucking not. You just ran off, again, and left me to do that for the guild.
Well, as an officer we are expected to set an example and do the right thing.
Fuck that. When we get back to the camp I'm telling Lanka that I quit as being an officer.
Okay, if that's what you really want. Anyway, did you find out where the cock is?
In more ways than one, yes. It's located in a cave about 5 miles south of here. However, the cave is occupied by a fierce monster.
Okay, what I suggest we do is this. We will go back to the camp and pass on this info. Then, they can send who they want to get the cock.
Agreed, but if you say one word about what I did here I will kill you. I swear it.
Don't worry, our motto is what happens on a quest stays on a quest, remember?
See that it does, or else.
Fucking hell mush, this is serious shit. What is it, dude?
It's one of my specials. The paper is lined in acid and then filled with a combination of ground ecstasy, cocaine, skunk and ground mushrooms.
Wow, it's mind-blowing, dude. This is serious shit, alright. I have never felt like this before. It's fucking far out, dude.
Be careful with it, Kwai. Don't smoke too much or you'll be so fucked you will be in a coma for weeks.
Dude, I was smoking and doing shit before you were born. I will be fine. Chill, dude.
Well, don't say I didn't warn you then.
Fuck. Look at that pig flying past us, mush.
Kwai, I think you've had enough. Seriously, this is heavy shit, mate.
Watch out, dude. A dive-bombing elephant.
Kwai, you noob. Fuck, I knew he couldn't handle this. I better go get some help. They will kill him when they find out.
Hi, guys. Come and dance with me. Come on, don't be shy. After a dance we can go to my tent for some rumpy pumpy. Fucking hell, Lanka, what have you done to me?
I made it very clear to you at the airport, Kwai, that if you consumed anything not approved by the WHO, I would shave your head bald and carve twat on your forehead.
But you have left stupid tufts of hair and dressed me in a fucking pixie outfit. I look fucking stupid. How can I go outside looking like this? I will be a laughing stock.
Well, you were warned, so you only have yourself to blame. The outfit was Shara's idea.
I'll kill Torsten. I hate you, Lanka. Look what you've done to me.
I think you look kind of cute in your little pixie outfit, Kwai. Anyway, we have burnt your clothes so you will have to wear that until we get back to Tyria next week.
I will never forgive you for this, you bitch.
Anyway, I have got to go get some cocks so can't chat anymore. See you later, pixie boy.
I'll get you back for this, Lanka. Mark my words. Guys, I wouldn't go in there. It's way too dangerous and there is no way in hell we're going to get any cock.
What's the problem in there, Kost?
At the end of a long tunnel it opens into a huge room and in there is a mother of a dragon standing over the cock. Seriously, guys, it's certain death to pursue this.
Well, if that's the case, John, I think you should volunteer for this.
Bloody hell, Diane, are you trying to get me killed?
Sounds like your days are numbered, Berlin. Anyway, I'm out of here. Got a gig tonight so can't be late. Nice knowing you, Berlin.
I'm not going to die, Kost. There is no way Carrier is sending me in there.
We'll be fine, dude. I'll come with you and with my Uber pound skills the dragon won't stand a chance.
Josty, no offense, mate, but I've seen your skills enough to know that this just makes me even more determined to not go in there.
John, you're such a pansy. You will get your ass in there with Justy and man up, now.
Yes, Diane dear, going now dear. Come on then, Uber Pound, let's go see this dragon.
And if you don't get the cock then don't come back.
Yes, Diane dear.
So, I just don't know what to do if it happens again, Lanka.
Well, I think the best thing you can do if Morv can't get it up again is to see the guild's medic and ask for some Viagra.
But if I give Morv the Viagra he will feel half a man. I can't do that to my baby.
Do what I do with Oxen Mim, I crush the Viagra and put it in his food. This way he is hard whenever I need it.
I still think Morv would be upset that I am having to give him Viagra though.
Mim, You don't tell him. Oxen doesn't have a clue that I do this to him.
Oh my god, Lanka, you naughty girl. Damn good idea though, I will see the medic when we get to the camp. Thanks for your help with this.
Fucking hell, Justy, look at the size of that thing. How the fuck are we going to get the cock?
I will cast one of my flame bolts. I am way too powerful for any dragon to be able to withstand the damage it will cause.
Justy mate, hate to burst your bubble but I seriously think you will regret it if you try.
Watch this, Pullen. Death bitch, suffer the power of Uber Pound.
Fucking hell, Justy, you've pissed it off now. Azoon, Justy has just been taken out by a big fucking dragon. I need an strike to kill this fucker. Okay, don't take long please or I will be toast too. I've got the cock. I will need help to carry them out of here but it's safe now and there are some stairs that will give you easier access to the room.
I'm really proud of you, John, and as a special treat I will give you a good spanking tonight and wear the cat suit.
Oh what, awesome. Will you use the strap on to Diane?